Alright, so I just needed to take a little pause for the pause. Maybe we're back. Interviewing Claudia Reid. This is Manny of Iron Coalition.
Yeah.
And Iron Coalition right here. At Steel Gym, 146, West 23rd, New York, New York. Claudia, you were talking about earlier about how to go about getting a sponsor.
Yeah.
You said to find a sponsor is somebody who just came out, just starting out.
Yes.
What if they're not really reputable? And they may sound good, they may look good, but
I would say that's a good question. What do you mean as far as like reputable? Like if they
reputable meaning they don't have much to offer, but at the same time they say they're gonna do this and they're gonna do that, but they don't do it.
But there's a lot of them are like that. A lot of them are like that.
Well.
You have to, as far as like with my experience, you have to put it out there and say, look, I'm this and I'm that, okay? And I think that you and I can make it work, or just get rid of them, basically. Don't waste your time.
What about stores?
Oh, that's easy. I don't like being sponsored by stores.
Why not? Because most stores have everything that you would need. You just tell them what you want and... You don't think the stores will help? Or?
No, not really. I mean, stores can help depending on the person that owns it. It's not the store. It's the person behind the store. Okay? If the person behind the store give you a lot of promises and they don't fall through with it, that's a problem.
That's where they got to get got. Little Jimmy going to get got.
You know, it's like for example, let's just say, for example, I have a t-shirt. I'm coming out with a Muscle Talk or t-shirt. And I go to this store, I don't know, maybe Brooklyn, Queens, wherever. Okay, and I know that people know me, and you know I'm reputable, you know, and I do things to, you know, I have the ability to bring money to your place. And you say, okay, well, you know what? Don't worry about this. We'll work out a deal, you know, and we'll make the t-shirt or whatever. And let's say that don't happen.
What you going to do? Did Jimmy going to get got?
I would do this and get me. I do this by myself with my own money and my own capital. Or maybe use somebody or get somebody else.
But Claudia.
Yes.
Will little Jimmy get got?
I would.
Little Jimmy going to get got. That's all I have to say.
All jokes aside, I think that when, you know, it makes you look pretty bad as a business person if you don't follow through with your thing. Because if I turn around and promise people, say, you know what, you could be on my show and I'll do this for you. I'm supposed to do it.
What about those who just don't know any better, who want to sponsor people and don't do anything? Expect people to do stuff for them.
All right. First of all, that's a clown circus right there.
I mean, there's people out there, I heard somebody be called a Mr. Envious. Mr. Envy, but I know.
Oh, Manny, what are we going to do?
I don't know what we're going to do, Claudia. But I'm so scared that I'm going to get got. I'm going to get got. My name is Little Jimmy.
You know what? You know what's so funny? This is my opinion about this. I don't mind. I could get sponsored by a garbage man who goes home 9 to 5. If he's willing to do something, we got a business together. My whole thing is that there's certain people out there that make promises and they put a lot of, can I curse?
Yes, you can.
They put a lot of shit in these athletes' heads telling them that they're going to get them far. But then my question is, why do athletes have to pay the fee to compete? I thought sponsorship was covers the
Well, I can speak on that behalf.
Why is it they only could do pro New York?
No, you didn't.
New York shows.
No, I attest to that. That it depends on what agreement the sponsor and the athlete has. Let's take for instance, I want a clothing sponsor. Where am I going to get out of it? I like to know what I'm going to get. Yeah, because most clothing sponsors they like to have something pushed for them. But there are some out there who just don't do what they're supposed to do. They just use you. And little Jimmy got to get got on that one, too.
Let me see. Clothing companies?
Well, as far as I know, clothing companies...
I had one, too.
I thought. But I was wrong, too.
Let me see. I was promised... You know how many companies come to me and ask me, I want to sponsor your show? And things like that. Let me tell you, this one clothing company I had, and nobody really knew that person. Not really. And
who are we talking about again? Oh, I'm sorry, I must have dozed off what your company you're talking about.
And what happened is that I'm the one, I would say, besides another athlete, both of us worked together and put this company on the map. Now, every time I posted something or posted a t-shirt of this company, people responded to it and actually ordered the t-shirts.
No.
Yes. And then, actually, I got the company an athlete who ended up going crazy and is on the run and ain't really doing much for him.
You don't say.
Yeah. The athlete is not doing nothing. Only thing he's doing is just putting prayer verbs on there, which doesn't sell the shirt. No, forgive me, God, it's not like that. But the point is that person never really did anything for me. But, you know, it's so funny now. Now I'm doing everything for myself.
That's the only way to go.
Secondly, there's another clothing company that said to me that, you know, we'll send you some stuff and you can interview with your... I'm still looking.
They never sent it to you?
Never sent it to me.
My gosh. They should be tarred and feathered.
But here's the thing. All you athletes out there, if you go with a clothing company, make sure that they have a website and make sure they put you on the website. Now, if you deal with an international company, make sure that your picture is on their website.
Your picture.
And make sure that you're not stuck on Facebook, okay? You understand what I'm saying? Because, you know, these people, these clothing companies, not all of them, some of them, will use you to get money from places that they can't even cross the border to get, but they concentrate on people next door that can, and they take the pictures with people next door and have them on the website, and then you're stuck there on Facebook and nobody knows you. My question is it worth it? Is it?
I don't think so. It's okay. Like going to McDonald's and ask for a hamburger and you get something, a frozen burger. Oh, I'm sorry, that's what it is. That's why I go to Burger King. Free plug.
Yeah. Let me explain something to you. Get paid. You're in the business to get paid. Just like baseball. Baseball players started off loving the sport. They get paid for it. Get paid. I'm not saying that you don't want, you know, if you want to go for just exposure, make sure you get something that is worth it. But cash is king.
And
most of these supplement companies, they're making the money and they're bringing it. No offense to supplement companies because I got a lot of friends in them. But here's the key. Some of them bring in the money and not dispersing it out. And then the only thing you're getting out of it is pills.
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 Powder.
Powder.
Pills.
Pills.
And more powder.
And more powder. Yes.
But then you have to think about the flight cost, the hotel cost, the fee to compete. All of that's coming out of your pocket.
All that.
Sometimes it's good to be sponsored by just name only, but make sure if you do it by name only, make sure you do it by a reputable company like BSN, Gaspari, who else?
Muscle Tech.
Muscle Tech.
Yeah.
Yeah, who else? You know.
People who've been around for a while.
The Jay Cutler companies, the Ronnie Coleman companies. The Yamagishi companies.
Anybody and everybody that has a name that has athletes that they take care of.
Now, one thing I can tell you about just farming, everybody gets paid. I know that for a fact.
Everybody gets paid.
Everybody. Even a cleaning man is doing well because Richard Gaspari take care of his people.
He take care of everybody.
But the thing is that when you deal with a company that's just starting out, it's a good thing too, but make sure you're getting something out of it. Make sure you sign a contract saying that when you bring in 6 months' time, when you bring in a certain amount in the quarter, make sure you get something out of it. Don't be with a company and don't get paid.
What about videos and they use you on YouTube and you have no say-so after the fact? Should they take them down if you're no longer with the company?
I would take it down.
No, but they have the video.
And they have the videos.
What if they don't? Let's say you have you were sponsored by a workout facility type workout machine type thing, and you're no longer with the company, but they still use your likeness. What if they're under contract to use it for a year, or unless the contract is broken?
You can sue them.
All right. Now, Claudia, since we turned this whole thing around, you were supposed to interview me. You see, I did a switcheroo on you. Mm-hmm. I interviewed Claudia Reid. Oh, damn. Yeah. All right, before we go, well, I got one more question.
Sure, anything.
One more question.
You know, I keep it straight.
One more game.
Okay.
The question I'm going to ask you.
Uh-huh.
As far as athletes go,
uh-huh.
what should sponsors look for in an athlete?
Oh.
Three good things.
First, I know for a fact. Your body ain't going to sell. It's your mouth. What comes out of it. You got to be confident. Okay? That's number one. Two, you got to be there on time. Three, when you do an interview like this, make sure you know what you're talking about. Make sure you talk and you sell the product. Like the Iron Coalition, if I was under the Iron Coalition, I can sell it like this. I don't need a script.
Iron Coalition, baby.
Don't join something. If you know that you cannot talk, you know that you can't talk, you know that, and you need, and you can't, and you don't listen to what people are saying, you're going to get kicked out every time, and it's not going to look good for you. The key is your mouth. You got to talk. Sell a product.
Say it loud. Say it proud.
Talk.
Talk.
When you go on interviews, like for instance, I had a couple of interviews. Let me tell you. Maybe like, I don't know. I love everybody on my show, but this one I had to delete. I had somebody in the show that just totally disappointed me to the point where I had to like, it was like being on the show by myself, like every 15 minutes. And I had to work hard to get the information I needed out. The key is to be yourself, know what you're talking about, keep your head straight, and be willing to jump at an opportunity. And don't create things that you don't know anything about. Okay? If you know that you created something, you need to know how many people are coming. And first of all, you need to know the right people. And if somebody knows what they're doing and they can help you, take the help.
Take it.
Because money is, listen, regardless, no matter how you look at it, money is the key to everything. And you can use it negatively or you can use it positively. Me, as far as like Manny and I's company, is positive. We take the money, we roll it back into the company to make the athletes look good. Because you know what? When they look good, we look good. And then there's more business coming in. Please, for heaven's sakes.
Be yourself.
Make sure you put positive pictures. Oh, another thing I want to mention too. Another thing. You see this? I got a weave.
Weave?
I got hair, believe me, but I don't use it unless I have to. Okay? Because when you process your hair and you curl it and things like that, it breaks off. Okay? I can take this off and let my hair come out. If you need a weave, do not be ashamed to use it. Okay? A majority of figure people, I have friends right now that have hair down to here, long hair, naturally, but they wear wigs, they wear weaves, wear a weave. Because the thing is that the judges are looking at you. Okay? It's not about your body, it's the whole effect. And if you have one of those faces where your hair goes all the way back up to here, okay? See, I got a big forehead, see, but I can do things with it. I can put a bang on it or push it back. Okay, if you need to, wear something like this. It's only $9.99. This is yak. $9.99. Put a weave in your head. Okay? Put a weave in your head. Okay? And make sure when you take pictures, don't pick. I always tell people, don't take pictures in your house. Don't do it. If you're going to take pictures, make sure you have a solid colored wall so it looks professional. And clean up after yourselves. Don't take pictures with all the clothes on the bed and all the stuff like that. I'm tired of seeing pictures like that. Wendy's supplement company, and I'm not kidding, Manny. I travel.